स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं कृपापूर्णं जगत्पतिं हरिषड्वर्गजेतारं नित्यानन्दगुरुं भजे स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं.
That's a very beautiful story about a great saint called Dakshinamurti Swamigal. His presence was such an intense presence, so powerful. He was from southern part of India, a very highly evolved, enlightened being. He was a Paramahamsa, means never used to wear clothes. Always lived a life of freedom. No clothes, nothing. Just he will sit in the forest under a banyan tree. Banyan tree was somehow associated with enlightened masters for quite a long time. I tried to dig out why the banyan tree is connected with enlightened masters. Still, I am yet to come up with the mystical connection. Logically, I am not able to find out the reason. But from time immemorial, there is a deep connection between banyan tree and enlightened masters. That's one funny thing. He was sitting under the banyan tree. His presence used to be so intense. Such an intense presence, you can touch and see. You can touch and feel God in His presence. Neither you need to talk, nor He needs to talk. One of the court poet, each court will have a poet. In that country, one poet from the court, the official poet, sang 1,000 verses on that saint, saying that he is the greatest warrior. If you kill 1,000 elephants in the war, you will be given that title, the greatest warrior, and the 1,000 songs will be offered in praise of you. This poet sang that. In that same meter, it is called Bharani. In the same meter, he sang 1,000 verses to that saint, praising the power or the heroic qualities of that master. When king came to know about it, his ego got hurt, because that king is the only guy who killed 1,000 elephants in the war. In that whole region, he is the only guy who had that a song and title. Always the politicians feel their ego is hurt whenever they see the name and fame or the attention is gathering, because they thrive in attention. See, with the living masters, they do not thrive based on attention. If none of you are here, I'll be doing the same job what I am doing now without moving my mouth. That's all. When I was sitting in my room, I am doing the same job of radiating the presence. Understand? My job is not done by the words which I am uttering. It is done by the presence. You may ask why I am uttering more words. Just to make you silent. If I am not talking, you will be talking. You will not receive, you will not be imbibing the subtle, mild work which I am doing. Masters thrive by their very presence. People thrive by the master's attention towards them. But with political leaders, politicians, they thrive by the attention given to them. It is number game. He was hurt, very deeply hurt. He called that poet and said, justify your decision of singing the same, in same meter, same thousand songs about that beggar, naked beggar, who is sitting under the banyan tree. You sang thousand verses on him, singing his glory and his heroism. Justify, otherwise your head will be cut. Because that is the only key with which the kings are ruling the country. The poet said, I don't have any reason or justification. You can kill me. I have no problem. Because I achieved what can be achieved by the human mind and the human body. This body and mind, what maximum peak it can experience, it has experienced already by his presence. In his presence, I have experienced the peak which I can have through this body mind. So now there is no use by this body mind. If you want, you can separate them. You can destroy them. I have no problem. But I can tell you one thing. Because I ate your food, I wanted to tell one word. If you have time or little patience, try going and sitting in his presence only once. That's all I am saying. Nothing else. This guy, this king, fortunately, even though he was caught by ego, he heard many stories about enlightened beings in the earlier times, in the young age. That is one great thing in India. One great thing in India. Sometime you may have a mood swing, you may have ego, arrogance, depression, but always you know corner of your mind, heart, the existence of enlightened beings is true, an existence of higher conscious state is true. If you work, you can have it. That trust will be there in all Indians who lived inside the villages or the area where the tradition is alive. Because from the young age, you will see hundreds of sadhus, the wandering mendicants, and you will hear hundreds of stories. You cannot escape or move away from the living spiritual tradition. Every street will have at least 2-3 temples. One beauty with the Vedic temples is they are not just educating organization. They are energy centers. They are energy centers. When you go and come back, you have some experience added to your being. Not just words. No. It is not just the pulpit from where a preacher or a priest or a swami can speak. He just speaks, no. It is an energy center. When you go in and come out, you carry something inside yourself. Something is added to you. Something is added to you. He knows there is something beyond him. So he decides, all right, let me give a chance before killing this poor guy. After all, it's a 1-hour journey. He goes there. Now the story takes a new turn. It's a such a beautiful, intense description. The king goes with all his whole paraphernalia. Means ministers, the citizens, the leading citizens, all of them go there. There was such an intense, vibrating silence. Not only he, the enlightened being, was silent, Even the tree was celebrating that silence. The tree was standing on the silence. It was rooted in silence. Its movements were celebrating the silence. The moment King entered the banyan tree's shadow, something happened in him. He goes near. He came with the idea of straight away shouting or questioning. But suddenly, understand, when you observe an intense silence in master's body language, whether you want it or not, it will penetrate your inner space. People ask me many times. In India, 30,000-40,000 people sit and listen for 5-6 hours the public discourses and darshans, satsangs. At least it will be 3 hours. If there is some question answer or darshan, it will go more than that. In India, it is very difficult for that many people to sit silently, because they are habituated only for political meeting. After 5-10 minutes, you can clap your hands and just get up and go. No problem. You need to give only attendance. But here, in our satsangs, it is not mobilized crowd. People ask me, and especially people who knows how difficult it is to create that mass and make them sit silently, they ask, for hours, 3-4 hours, how these people are sitting silently and listening intensely, and not a single person moves out. All I do is, before starting the discourse, I'll just sit like a stone for a few moments. Complete silence. When you are connected to somebody who is radiating intense silence, suddenly you will see the same silence is descending in your inner space and you are settling down. The transmission of silence happened between the master and the king, and king not only did not utter any word, forgot about any word which he wants to utter. Just all he received is one nod by the master indicating sit. He just moved the head. Sit. King sat. Master did not even utter the word sit. He just moved the head, meaning sit. He just sat. Because king sat, the whole army sat. And master again resumed, entered into the silence. The silence was so intense. Neither king wanted to break, nor he had the energy or guts to break. It continued for 1 hour, 2 hour, 1 day, second day. Of course, beyond logic, 1 week passed, 1 week over. Neither king felt the thirst nor hunger or the idea of time. Understand? You will have idea of time or boredom only when there is thoughts. When there are no thoughts, you won't have an idea of time or boredom. Time is defined by thoughts. When thoughts drop, there is no time. There is no time. And story says, after 1 week, Master was so compassionate. He just moves his eyes, looks into the poet, his disciple, in a very jovial way. I think kingdom needs king back. To take care of the kingdom, he has to be there. He smiles. Suddenly, all of them come back to the normal mind or mood. They realized 1 week passed. There was no thought, no communication, no food, no water, no sleep, deep fulfillment physically, mentally, and spiritually. Understand? If this is just a story, it would have been recorded. Because it happened, the king built a beautiful, huge temple again under this same banyan tree. We have a temple and a mutt near a place called Tiruvarur. It's called Dakshinamurti Swamigal Mutt. It is created by that king. Understand? Kings will not do anything unless it is their strong experience. It was such a strong experience. King turns and tells that poet, "Thank you for guiding me to him. Now all I wanted to tell you is 1,000 songs is too less for him. 1,000 is too less for him. Please add some more. Please add some more. Let you sing. I'll see that it is engraved in stone all over this temple. The whole thing is engraved on stone by that king all over the temple. That power, that intensity, that energy." Of course, the king was fortunate to have that experience. He was also intense to have that experience. When you are intense, even in the outer world, if you are intense, suddenly you will see, you don't need too many words from Master. Few words are enough. It leads to the experience.